Ta-da! Oh yeah, this was a really, really long and almost boring process. Sorry guys if I don't want to show you everything what I did, which steps after which steps, but you guys definitely have to go on a way of assembly guide. On a first look, I couldn't find any problem or any more mistakes like what I did here with the frontonel connectors. Let me show you the backside of the PCB, and now we will follow the assembly guide, yeah? We have to install the display filter. I really like this old-fashioned red 7-segment display. Germans call this Sekundenkleber. this Sekundenkleber. So I don't wanna fuck up the display. So let's wait a bit. Okay, just like really just like this. Ah, look what it did with my finger. Yeah, it's it's really interesting. It don't wanna stick to nowhere, only to your fingers. Oh my god. How I can measure gummy with the caliper, eh? 3.5? 3.3, okay, we can accept. Okay, so we have something similar, like on a picture. Insert the filter frame into the front panel and lock it into the place with the two locking washers. Ah, this one. Now we have to... Oh! Very small. Kind of. It's wobbly. No, it's not wobbly. And then the next one. Come on. Of course you don't want to go. Kind of. I think I will modify this. I'm not fully happy with this solution, but from outside it's just looking gorgeous, yeah? The next one is front panel and PCB assembly. In. Yeah, beautiful. Tick, 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 tick. It will be not easy, I have a feeling already. Yeah. So, drop it here. No. I don't understand. Okay, this is going well. The first, the second, the third, but the fourth one. It's just, I hope I didn't break the panel. So I will suggest to the Sound Skulptor guys or to use a different kind of XLR connector. By the way, this is really nice with this locking mechanism. Or if they will change a bit here, the CNC works for the backside. Everything is just really rigid and solid. Beautiful example of nice engineering. Okay, next step is to install the case connection, which is a grounding point. So what I'm missing from here is some kind of cuts on a side to hold the PCB, or maybe I'm just fully stupid, so maybe I want to build everything like industrial. Put and two. Put front panel. If the dog's off the leash, then the dog's gonna bite. If the dog's in the ring, then the dog's gonna fight. If the dog's on the west coast, then I'm fucking with you. Let him hold that nigga. Oh, guys, he's like beautiful. Oh, look at this. I really like it. Now we have to go to the testing phase. Okay, let's start it. Insert the switcher 2 module. Ta-da! Is this one. And then remove all ICs. Ha ha ha! You see, guys? So this is why I not installed any ICs. We just out with couple of millivolts. Let me check the minus 16. So we out with half volt. We have to find a way how we can get rid of from this half volt on the negative rail. Test point 5. So 5 volt. Yeah, it's really nice. Check the 3.3 volt. Not here, it's here the 3.3 volt. So it's 3.24. U14, U18, U20 and U21. RS-485 interface. Oh, guys! Industrial interface. And I have this interface on my mixer. And in my mixer I can set up different commands for different buttons. So, oh, it will be really nice if I can control the monitor controller with my mixer. Beautiful! And make it so, yeah. It's so good. No. You are so tiny. It's alive! It's alive! So it's meaning now the microcontroller is loaded up, the bootloader and everything. They're not using some kind of special relay driver chips, which is done by Maxim. In my product development, I chose this a bit expensive special relay drivers. Later on, when I will upload the videos about my new product, you guys will see why. Because I'm using total different relay technology. So the great things about these shift registers, they are really jelly beans. So it's meaning you can get them from everywhere for 10 or 20 cents or something like this. My design is a bit different. Now I just remember for my 8-bit computer time when I was young. Okay, U10, it's again a shift register and it came to this corner if he wanna go in. Why you not wanna go in? Just go in. Yeah, yeah, nice. Mark on a PCB and mark on a IC relay test. And now they're switching the resistor network to different configuration. I'm using the same technology in my one, but I'm using one more bit. More steps you have, more problem you can get. So I stopped on 8-bit and I stopped on 7-bit. Yeah, very nice. Bit noisy. Much more noisier than my design. And this is the next issue, which is not true in my product. Let me show you. So now, if you adjust it somewhere, okay, let's say 39 dB, if you switch off the device, all the relays will release. So you hear it? So all the relays is releasing. So there is no way to switch to the desired level and totally, completely switch off this controller. And I hope it will jump back to the last volume what I adjusted to minus 31. Yeah, it's nice. So it's keeping the last settings on the volume level. So let's play now with the other relays. Mono, differential, and the output selector, 2, 3, 4. Okay, everything is working with the relays. Next step is to install the op amps, I think. Okay, the next step is to zeroing out the op amps. I have to power up the system and left here for a while, because we have here this power supply unit and also this voltage regulators, and I really like to get them a bit warm. And now is the time to power up myself. I need around 2 ampere or 3 amp or something like this on 100 volt. So let me find some nice capacitor. Ah, here. Okay. Red bull, red bull, red bull, red bull, red bull. After 200 watt of input into my brain and a couple of minutes of warming up the device itself, I realized something. This voltage drift what we have here on the positive 16 and on a negative 16, so it's all together, it's like 0.6 volt, which is really huge in this kind of precision. It's almost 5% out from the specifications. These op amps generally, they're coming from the factory with really high precision laser cutted offset adjustment inside. But of course, in this monitor controller, we have a possibility to adjust this offset voltage. You don't have to worry about this, because this 7 millivolt here, it's like nothing after the coupling and after all of your gears or whatever. But I really care about it. So then I find the problem source is this half volt difference on a negative rail. I highly recommend to the sound sculpture guys to modify the plan of this monitor controller to make sure we can adjust here this minus 16 and positive 16 volt power source. But I know it's not an easy job, because this LM337 chip is very sensitive on a current which is flowing from the adjustment leg back to the ground. If here we have 1% precision resistors, so what is mean? This 1% difference, because you see the two numbers, so it's 10 times bigger than this one, it's causing almost like 11% of differences between the real world and between what you planned here. So because of that, they have to bring here some kind of adjustment solution. For example, put here a 2 kilo ohm resistor and then a simple linear potmeter which is going from 0 to 5k, let's say. Or same here, let's say add here a 150 ohm resistor and bring here like a 400 ohm potentiometer, simply linear potentiometer. Then on that way, we can adjust the adjustment current, which is really, really, really important for this voltage regulator. You see why? So this is the adjustment current. This is a really important factor. And also we can adjust the voltage divider here. Later on I will do some really small PCB here with my solution, but at the moment my version here, what I try to do is add the additional parallel resistor to the R2, which is here 3.9K resistor. On that way I can lower this resistance with really, really tiny, tiny, tiny bits, and I had a guessing like, you know, like it will be around 100k or something like this. So the unknown resistor. So then I went through the calculations and I get 143k on this additional resistor. So this is what I did on a bottom, like a really small budge at the moment. So here is my budge. This is a 150k resistor because I don't have 143k resistor. By the way, guys, this is in my case. It can be your monitor controller from the Sound Skulptor will have a total different voltage differences, or maybe will be totally perfect. But in my case, this is what I have to apply. So don't apply this budge in your monitor controller. So this is a really specific. Okay, so now I just installed here my Sony Action Cam to show you guys the Schlumberger benchtop multimeter display. And I also can see here the voltages. Unbelievable cute technology. If I take this one now, and this is the other end of the Schlumberger, let me show you. So if I'm zeroing out, and now I'm on five-digit mode because I really like the speed of the five-digit mode. On 6.5 digit, we can see even millions of voltage differences. Let me press the zero. It will average out the noise from the cables. Now we are on absolutely 0.00000 volt. In the past, you know, guys, we have here this -5 volt differences, and now after the budge, we have on the positive side 16.800 of volt, and here we have -16.1100 of volt. Really, is not a big. So let's now check the offset voltage on the first op amp. So for that we came a bit closer with the grounding point. So let's come here, and then where is the test point one? So this is the test point one. Bang! 0.00001 volt, which is absolutely nothing. Let me show you guys how it looks if we make this a bit wronger. So let's adjust this offset to the, you see? So this is a negative offset, and we will zero it out absolutely to 0.00. Or even I can go now to the 6-digit mode, and then we can see here a really, really nothing. So this is the perfect null offset. Let's change back to the 5-digit mode and come to the test point 3, and no, other direction. So let's adjust to null. I have a guess here, like this will be 0.1 something. Yeah, it's absolutely zero. Test point 2. This is a really nice technology. Unbelievable, Sony. How they did it, I no have clue. So now we have 0.00 something something. And we can lower this one to absolutely zero. Almost. I almost there. 0.00. So this is absolutely 0.00. Let's check on a 6.5-digit mode. Okay, I can accept this. Because now, guys, the whole case is open. Let me show you. If I just came closer with my finger, then you see? So this is the test point 4. And we have 8 billion of volt differences. So let me adjust it. So 0.00 something, nothing volt differences. Okay, and now jump to the 6.5-digit and check it. Okay, this I can accept. This will cause nothing difference on our output. I think here we have a really nice offset adjustment now, and I think now we can finish the assembly completely. Nice. The headphone amplifier test. The two driver op amps installed into the headphone section, and let me see what they suggest how we can test it. Connect the voltmeter red probe to the test point 9 and check that the DC voltage is very close to zero, a few millivolts from 0 volts. Okay, so switch on my Schlumberger camera. What? It's like nothing. Okay, if we change the inputs, nothing is changing. And if we turn the pot, what will happen? Nothing. Very good. But really interesting, guys, it's so precise. There is no difference between the left and the right channel. Let me show you. So this is the left channel, I think, TP9. And the TP10 is the right channel. Nothing difference between the two. And I'm much more interested on a differences. So this design is so elegant, even if it's using two total different circuits to drive the left and the right channel, you guys can see what's the differences between the two. Unbelievable. And by the way, now you can see how these voltages are drifting back to almost to zero. By the way, no, guys, this level of offset differences is like nothing. You saw it on the input, we have zero. Here we have like 1 millivolt functional test. Connect the stereo input signal to the input 1 XLR and connect monitors to the output 1 XLR. It is my EMU 1820 sound card, what we will use as a generator. Output 1, output 2. Now I will change the output to balanced, and you guys will hear a relay is clicking in the docking station. Now I have here a possibility to add here an insert as a signal generator or test tone. So let me add here, and here I can choose different kind of signal generation. For the main moment, let's choose the normal oscillator and of course 1 kHz and minus 20 dB. Voila! Okay, let me put this headphone on my head, and I just want to hear if there is any kind of differences between the two sides. We have a bit of problem on really low volume settings in the headphones. So around here on 1% or something, the left channel is already start to work, but the right channel nothing. But after, let's say, just a tiny bit of touch, and then everything is coming back to the normal, so then there is no balance issue. So I think this is mainly a differences in the potentiometer itself, so it's not a problem of the electronic. If we want to improve the volume settings for the headphone output, then we have to replace this potentiometer to something much more higher quality. But the space here is really limiting what we can do here. But by the way, it's have enough power to drive this really high impedance headphone. So if now I will plug the 32 ohm consumer headphone to here, I think I'm 100% sure this will blow up. So this is the headphone, and I just put closer to my microphone, yeah? Very low. So I really like the headphone amp. Clean as is, so no hiss, no noise, nothing, even on a highest level. Check inputs 2 to 6 on output 2 to 4. So this is my Yamaha monitor speaker. Okay, output 1 left. Let's plug it here. Time to do a test, no? Sorry guys for the big mess here, but we're still in a construction phase of the media section in my studio. We are on minus 63 decibel setting on our output. It's not fully silenced. I hear something. So this is the level of the signal that is come from the speaker. if we switch to the mute. Aha.
Nothing.
Nothing from the speaker. And let me rise up the volume. So now. Very nice. Okay, let me change the input. Nice. So now we are on a minus 40 dB altogether because the generator is all minus 20. So minus 20, input 1, input 2, nothing, 3, nothing, 4, nothing, 5, nothing, 6, nothing. Go back to the input 2 and change the XLR to input 2. Okay. Nice. I don't wanna go here to the 3 and a 4, I'm 100% sure it's absolutely working. Tonight I will play a bit more with this monitor controller, and tomorrow I will do this programming and digital setup or whatnot. And I also will install the potmeter knobs here to the front, and I will close the lid and the bottom part of the monitor controller, and that's it. Guys, this is what the signal is doing, yeah? So, signal came from here, came to these relays, and then came to these relays, and then came to these relays. This is the volume, and then it's coming to these relays, then it's choosing one output, and it's going out, and on this cable, and then it came out from the speaker. Bye, guys.